and take the juice in spoonful doses for any kind of stomach problem relating to tumors or cancer or any such ailment. But you have to use them when they are real ripe. The roots of this plant now is used as a to regulate the glands, and a lot of studies being done on the roots of the pokeweed now, because they're getting very good response from AIDS patients, so show a lot of promise in the health field. And it's been used traditionally as far back as you can go, both as a food and a medicine. That's the pokeweed, P-O-K-E weed. Now, this bush that you see here, this bush is known as the spice bush. When you pick a leaf and crush it, it's very aromatic. It's like a spice. You can use it in the same way as you would cinnamon, you know. Same way you can use the spice bush as a tea. It warms the blood, keeps you warm in the winter time. That's what the Native Americans use it primarily for. The red berries, those are used also as a spice and to bring down fever. But the leaves also as a tea will bring down fever. That's why the other name for this plant is the fever bush, because it's so effective in bringing down a fever. That's the spice bush. The twigs of this plant, you cannot use it same way as you would chew stick. Chew on it and the end of the stick will frizz out into a brush, and the Native Americans use that to clean their teeth. Because the substance from the spice bush breaks up tartar, it sweetens the breath, sweetens the stomach as it goes down, and it makes the teeth white and pearly white and shiny, and kill the bacteria that cause tooth decay. That's the spice bush. Let me see, we're going to talk now about the mullein, the great mullein. Mullein is one of those very, very important herbs for anything with the respiratory organ, especially the lungs. Mullein will bring mucus up out of the lungs. It will stop coughing of blood bleeding from the lungs. You know what I mean? Anything, asthma, bronchitis, any tuberculosis, anything with the lungs, drink that mullein tea every day. Also good for the nerves, good for the blood pressure, you know, as a tea. So that's another one of those plants that you should try to encourage to grow in your environment, and always have some in the house. One get a cough, a cup of mullein tea will stop it right away. See what I mean? So one should really try to encourage the herbs like that to grow. Now the horsetail grass contains a lot of silica. So anyone who has any kind of skin problems, fingernail problems, bone problems, teeth problems, ear problems, should drink the horsetail grass as a tea. Very good to nourish the ear and give that the skin back that elasticity, and very good to make strong ear because of the silica that's in it. It also have a lot of other minerals, but that's the main mineral that it contains. A tea of the horsetail grass is also good for gallstones and things like that. Very good to people suffering from any kind of skin eruptions like eczema, psoriasis, along with correcting the diet, I might add, you know, staying away from the junk foods, you know. You'll see good results with if you're suffering from eczema or psoriasis. These plants that we are looking at here now, these are known as the plantain or the common plantain. There are two types of plantain. You have the common plantain and you have the lance leaf plantain. Both of them used primarily for the same purposes, but there are little differences in uses with both of them, which I'm going to explain in a little while. Let's deal with the common plantain first, the one that has the broad leaf. This one here, the broad leaf. It's primarily used for the eyes. Any eye problem you have, say you have inflammation on the eye.
Tenestelin, Ixlia Bear Maskan, welcome to the Bushman segment on Rockers TV every time. We will talk about the tuna plant. If you look right here, you'll see this is the what is known as the tuna plant. It grows in all of your tropical and subtropical regions like Florida, all of the Caribbean, South America, Africa, Asia. This is not just a medicine, but it's also a food. This is what it looks like. This is the foundation root, then these grow up from them. Most people know them. This is what a fully grown leaf, you know, basically a little bigger, a little smaller, but fully grown, look more like this. This is very good for all type of inflammatory ailments. It moves inflammation anywhere in the body. It is traditionally used for that. All you have to do is cut up one of these and put one of them in like a gallon of water. And instead of water, you drink that every day if you're suffering from arthritis, rheumatism, gout, all those type of ailments. You're going to get some dramatic improvement just by using that for all inflammatory ailments. Plus, it has a very easy, cool, smooth, cleansing and nourishing effect on the kidneys, the bladder, and the urinary tract. Are very nutritious again, but primary use, all inflammatory ailments, move excess water from the body, move inflammation from the body wherever it is, right? Using for thousands of generations, been using for that. It's also a food. It bears a fruit on the top of the leaves there, which turns red. Very delicious fruit, and that fruit is very rich in iron. If you are anemic and you live in regions where it bears, when that fruit is ripe, it has some little black seeds and red sap around it. You eat that, very good to supply you with iron and strengthen up your blood level. You can cook this in the Eastern Caribbean and Africa, Asia. They cut this into like string beans and eat it just like string beans. They also cut it up and steep curry it down, eat it instead of meat. You can also In the Caribbean, Eastern Caribbean, they cook it down with saltfish, codfish, and eat it that way. So it's a very good plant to know, both as a food and a medicine. It's known as a tuna or the puntia, prickle pear. Different places it's known as different things. But in Jamaica, we call it the tuna. In the Eastern Caribbean, they call it cochineal. In other parts, they call it prickly pear because of the fruit is known as a prickly pear. So that's it for this segment on the Bush Doctor segment. I am your Bush Doctor, Rahsaan Abdul Hakeem. And all these things you can get up at the Sundial Healing and Learning Center at 3609 Boston Road in the Bronx, right between 225th and 222nd Street. Peace and blessings. Tenanacho, Tanestelin, Ixlia Bear Maskan. Welcome to the Bushman segment on Rockers TV every time. We talk about the nutmeg. Very important, both as a medicine and a spice, right? If you look at, this is what a nutmeg looks like. When it's a fruit, this is a seed that's inside the fruit. You see this outer shell here? This is what is known as mace. This is what is known as mace, a very exotic spice. It's stronger than a nutmeg and have a more mellow look. I think you have a picture of the nutmeg in the back there. So this is like the mace. You can use this now there, toast it like, burn it, and add it with milk and give it to children, especially babies, for dysentery and diarrhea, to check the infantile diarrhea and dysentery. You can make a little tea with it, or you toast it and powder it up and put it with some milk or some juice and give it to the baby for diarrhea, etc. You can also make a tea with it for diarrhea and dysentery in adults. Now the actual nutmeg is inside this. I'm going to crack it and let you see. You see, this now is the actual nutmeg that's inside of it. See it break up. This is the spice. This is this, if like you're going to do a race and you have shortness of breath, asthma, anything with the breathing passages and the bronchial area, This is the thing, you make a tea with it, drink it, it clears the chest, open the breathing passages, enable more oxygen to go into your lungs. Likewise, if you are a runner or play soccer, when you're going to play, you suck on the nutmeg, a piece of the nutmeg. It's going to open the breathing passages, so you're getting more air into the lungs, thereby you're getting more oxygen. Your entire body is strengthened and rejuvenated. You can really move on them out there. You see what I mean? This you can also make a lotion with it by soaking it in say rum or alcohol, some kind of spirit. Crush it, grate it, put it in a rum, let it sit. You use that on the joints for any kind of arthritic pains, rheumatic pains. You can massage that onto the joints using the nutmeg tincture. You can make an ointment with it also. If you have chest congestions, pains in the chest, asthma, bronchitis, the chest stop up, just grate some of this nutmeg and put it in some coconut oil. Simmer it down in some coconut oil, and then you use that oil to massage the chest and the lungs, stuffiness in the head. You rub it in a little in the mole of the head, it loosen up all the mucus in the head and clear the breathing passages. Like when I go to Ethiopia and I'm going to walk, Ethiopia is very high, the air is thin, so it's less oxygen. And if you try to run around before you get climatized to the environment, you're going to be gasping for breath pretty soon. So what you do now when you go to those areas, you suck on the nutmeg during the day. It's going to open the breathing passages, let more air go into the lungs, so you'll be getting more oxygen. And most of those monasteries and ancient sites going back to ancient days and biblical times up on high mountains where you have to go really high and you have to walk more time. So it's a very important thing to have to open the breathing passages. Like again, I say shortness of breath, bronchitis, asthma, those kind of ailments having to do with the lungs, the breathing passage, the respiratory area. Make a tea with it, drink it, always suck on it. Going to keep, have you getting more oxygen in the lungs and prevent asthma attacks. And you know already, it's a spice porridge. You can also burn it as an incense in the house. And you can use it as in your spice when you're making porridge, pudding, cakes. You know the run-ins with that. That's the nutmeg. And like I say again, you can get all these things up at Sundial Healing and Learning Center where we do consultations. If you have an ailment you can pass through, we'll reason with you about it. We do consultation on certain days. You know, the number up there is 718-798-3962. That's 718-798-3962. Irie, I don't know, you're looking at this picture in the background. This is when Queen Makeda went to visit Solomon. This is our entourage with our bodyguards and servants, etc. You know what I mean? And when she went to drop some heavy knowledge on Solomon from Ethiopia and bring him some heavy gifts. You know what I mean? Because Ethiopia at that time was running things. You know what I mean? So that's the ancient copy of an ancient picture of when Queen Makeda of Ethiopia visited Solomon in Jerusalem. Sila. Tinestelin, greetings and welcome to the Bushman segment again on Rockers TV every time. My name is Rasan Abdul Hakim, your Bush doctor at your service. Today we're going to talk about cayenne pepper, sometimes known as goat pepper, all kind of bird pepper. They call it all kind of names. We know it as bird pepper in Jamaica. In Guyana, it's known as cayenne pepper, Africa goat pepper, all kind of names. But basically, most common name, bird pepper, cayenne pepper, right? This now is a serious, as a bush doctor, this is one of the ingredients you make sure you have with you all the time for emergencies. As a matter of fact, I have it in my medicine pouch here. One of the times I'm going to use a segment to show you what's in the medicine pouch so you can have a medicine pouch. But this is a main ingredient, the foundation ingredient. Anything wrong with you, regardless what it is, you get the cayenne pepper inside of you. Cayenne pepper, can bring one out of a heart attack within minutes. This is not, I don't read this in no book or no like a guy tell me, I see them do it. Come up in the country where I'm and come from, a place named Summer Hill in St. Anne's. You can't call doctor because doctor though, it's a joke thing that doctor don't come up in them region, right? So you have to, in every community, have a bush doctor who are a lady who know how to do things and what, how they do it. Someone going to a heart attack, you just have some powder, cayenne pepper, you know, if you have the ripe one off the tree, just crush it. And then just put in a little water, and somebody just grab the person's nose and their mouth open, and they throw it down the throat. And then as it go in the mouth, they let go the nose and grab the mouth. And when they draw the breath, it go right into the body. They have to swallow it, go right into the body. And once it gets into your body, it brings you out of a heart attack within minutes. It stops, cayenne pepper stops internal bleeding. It improves your circulation, it heals ulcers. If you have an ulcer pain right now, you put a little powder, cayenne, a little water and drink it right now. It will stop within minutes, that pain stop, because cayenne pepper heals ulcers. It stops internal bleeding within minutes. Normalizes your blood pressure. If it high, bring it down. If it too low, it bring it up. You know what I mean? Serious thing, it improves circulation. And these is just some of the basic things I'm telling you what it does, not the abundance of thing it does. It supplies you with iron, vitamin A, abundance of potassium. That is why it lowers the blood pressure, control the blood pressure because of the potassium. It will maintain your life signs. Though cure low, it bring that life sign down, go and maintain it until you can get somewhere where you can get treatment, the type of treatment you desire to get. You know what I mean? Because go and maintain your heartbeat, your pulse rate, go and keep your circulation going, go and keep the connection of nervous system to the brain in place. You know what I mean? So this is something you must always have in your house. If you get a cut right now, you just powder the cayenne pepper, put on it as a poultice. It goes stop the bleeding, prevent infection, promote the healing, and stop the pain, kill the pain as an anesthetic in the area. Cayenne pepper, both for internal and external uses. You can use it. They used to use this as tear gas against the British, the Coromantee people, known as Maroons. They used to powder it and burn it. That's tear gas. You can't deal with that. You have to leave the area. And the Coromantee people, derogatorily known as Maroons, they used to use that against the British forces when they were struggling in the Caribbean. They used to use that as a weapon. You see, so this is a very serious pepper which is used for multi-purposes, you know what I mean? You use it, you burn it in the house to drive away rats and insects, but you have to leave the house when you put it on the fire. You have to leave the house because it's going to drive any living thing, roach, rat, anything, go and leave the premises, and then you just come back, open up your windows, etc. That's the cayenne pepper, and those are the primary uses, and that's one of the reasons why you should always have it, whether on your possession or and in your household. It's an ingredient that can save your life, literally save your life. I've used it to relieve a lot of substances traveling with people, and you know what I mean, it and the busy. We're going to talk about the busy in another program, because the busy is the second order. Are equally important in terms of your medicine pouch and an emergency response to any kind of ailment. Irie, so peace and blessings every time. Then Anachu, Ixlia Bear Maskan, welcome to the Bush Doctor segment. I am your Bush Doctor, Rasan Abdul Hakim, right here on Rockers TV. Today we're going to talk about asthma. It's an ailment that's affecting our community very seriously. And asthma, you cannot talk about asthma in a few minutes and get to it, but we're just going to go through the basics and give you something that we can get some relief from it on the way to curing it. Asthma is an ailment directly related to diet, environment, and lifestyle. Asthma You eat a lot of milk, butter, egg, cheese, rice, flour, chicken, the dead meats, you know what I mean? It puts a lot of mucus in your body, and that mucus lodges in the breathing passages. The air can't get through to the lungs. That is what asthma is, restriction of air getting to the lungs based on the amount of mucus that's in the breathing passages. If you get excited and get tense, that area gets even smaller. The breathing patches tighten up more. You start to gasp for air. That's an asthma attack. Just to give it to you basically. There's a lot more to it than that. But just to give it to you basically, that's what asthma is. To cure asthma, all you have to do is to change your diet and your lifestyle and clean up what mucus is in the breathing passages and open it up. Simple. Some basic things that you can do is you can take like a nutmeg, suck on a nutmeg on a daily basis. Keep a piece of nutmeg in your mouth. Keep your breathing passages open so you're always getting a certain amount of air into your lungs. And you prevent asthma attacks or lessen them on the way to improvement. You have a number of herbs like the eucalyptus leaf, the jack in the bush, the pepper elder, the sweet basil. You can combine these herbs, make tea, especially the eucalyptus leaf. Make a tea with it, drink it on a regular. Mullein leaf is another good herb for asthma, bronchitis, anything with the breathing passages. But we have a Sundial Herbal Products, have an asthma formula here that they put together with a few traditional herbs of the Caribbean and Africa, which is excellent for asthma. The contents of this will make you 2 quarts of tea. You drink about 2 or 3 cups every day. You start to move that mucus out of your breathing passages. Get that mucus out there while you cut out the foods that put it in the mucus so you're on your way to a cure. You know what I mean? Another basic thing that you're going to do for the asthma, you're going to take the Sundial Wood Root Tonic in the morning, which is what's going to flush out your bladder, your kidney, urinary tract, move any mucus that's lingering there, you know. Clean the mucus out of your joints and your muscles and out of your bronchial tubes. Clean the mucus out of your body totally. That's what this is going to do. Clean your blood while it strengthens your blood because it's a tonic also. It strengthens the blood. The wood root tonic, Sundial tonic. You also have the Sundial bitters, the Coromantee, the Sundial bitters. You take this at night before you go to bed. This is going to clean out your stomach, intestine, bowels, colonic area. Clean that area out thoroughly. All the mucus that you cough up and swallow, it's going to clear that out while it assists to move the mucus out of the breathing passages. And doing that, the tonic, Sundial tonic first thing in the morning, the Sundial bitters last thing at night, 2 cups of the Sundial asthma blend. You can, if you want to have a tea, you drink the eucalyptus leaf, make a tea with that, drink a cup of that. If you want a different tea, you can drink that tea. Cayenne pepper. In every tea you take, put a little cayenne pepper in it, right? Garlic and olive oil. Every day take a spoon of olive oil, crush a piece of garlic in it with a dash of black pepper. Swallow that once or twice a day. That way start to clean the mucus out of your breathing passages and lungs, all them areas. The mullein leaf teas are one that you can combine with the eucalyptus leaf. Make a tea, drink a cup of that. And remember to do your breathing exercises in the morning, noon, and night to force the mucus out by pulling in through the nostrils like this, letting the chest expand, then releasing through the mouth. It's going to force the ears and air into the lungs, physically helping to move the mucus out of that area, right? The bronchial tubes, etc. So, look. At night when you sleep, crack a window so fresh air can come through so you can keep that mucus coming out. Coconut oil, rub your chest with coconut oil. Very important to loosen the mucus in the chest and the head. Rub it on your head, loosen all that mucus. God, that's all asthma is. Accumulation of mucus and soot from asbestos and smoke and all them things that is block your breathing passages. So all you have to do is to clean that out, watch the environment you're going, and watch the foods you eat. That's it for asthma. Peace and blessings. See you next time. him as a point of information, or everything here we talk about on these segments is available up at Sundial Healing and Learning Center, Coromantee Health Food Store, up in the Bronx at 3609 Boston Road, between 222nd and 223rd Street. That's in the Bronx. And our number is 718-798-3962. That's 718-798-3962. And we do consultations every Wednesday and Saturday from 10 o'clock in the morning. Peace and blessings.
Welcome, Blessings. Welcome to the seat of the Windward Maroons.
Thank you for having me.
And we're going to talk about the Woodwood Tonic. And the Woodwood Tonic is like aphrodisiac. We have like the prawn bark. And the prawn bark is like a natural strengthener for the body.
Right.
And the prawn is a tree that grows in the mountain. Beautiful trees and beautiful tree, and when you cut it, it smells good. When it's fresh, it smells nice.
And like, you were telling me that they put that in the chocolate tea?
Yeah, they put it in chocolate tea.
And they could work out in the field all day without eating?
Right. And that will make them feel filled with food all day. Hmm. But sometimes they come back by lunchtime and have big cooked lunch with like roots food and so on. So that's one that goes in the tonic. The prawn, and then we have the almond strength, and that one strengthens the whole body, like the joints and the muscles.
Like the name says, all man's strength.
Yeah. Right. And then we have...
And what does that plant look like now?
The almond strength is a vine, and it grows in the high mountain forest. And you can go and cut the vine, but when you cut the vine, afterwards, it sprung again, as springs again.
Right.
And then you have the powerful one now, which is the raw moon. And that one, most time, a man can drink just the raw moon alone to get his aphrodisiac or his sexual urge satisfied.
Does it just affect sexual urge? It makes that stronger. Does it also affect sexual performance?
Well, sexual performance, I would say.
So it makes a man more of a man.
Right, and it makes you get the urge too, because for example, if people go into menopause and they don't feel, you know, sexual.
So women can take it too?
Yeah, women take it too. Okay. Mostly when they go into menopause, you know that women don't really feel that way too much.
Right.
And then we have the chain root now. The chain root is one like, it's more like a yam. Like a yam, and it's more like the root, you use the root of it.
Uh-huh.
And that one now it's good for life, for fertility, like strengthen the reproductive system.
Uh-huh.
Like that. And then you have the black whist now. And the black whist is this one that has the gum, when you chop it, like, you know, like you see the gum resin,
uh-huh,
and where you cut it. So that now is like help to lubricate the joints. So like it enhances the performance of the joints more.
So you go out and you collect all five of these herbs.
Mm-hmm.
And then what do you do with them now to make your tonic?
Well, I will dry them. First you have to dry them for like 3 weeks. And after they're dried, you chop them up small and you wash them. Put them in a big pot of water. Like for example, I have like a 3 gallon pot. So I put that in the fire and like 2.5 gallon water. And then I will make all of these equal parts of roots and vines. And then I will wash them and fill the pot to the brim now. That when you put it in there, the pot full up. So you put it on the fire. I cook it on the coal fire or wood fire. I don't really cook it on gas. So I put it on the fire and it boil. When it start boiling, I put the fire low and make it stay there and simmer until the coal fire go out, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Simmer on a low fire and then you leave it overnight, because I mostly make it like in the evenings. So it has all night to just seep out all the properties. And the next morning, let's strain it off. And then you put some honey in it, sweeten it with some honey and a little molasses. And then you put it in bottle and make it ferment. And then you take 1 ounce 3 times a day.
1 ounce 3 times a day.
Yeah. And it makes you strong all around.
What would happen if you took more than that?
Well, you're not supposed to take more than 1 ounce because you don't want to overperform.
For men?
Yeah. For men, women, anyone who want to take it.
Okay.
Except children. No children.
Okay, thank you, Ivy.
You're welcome. I'm going to show you this herbs, and we call it piaba. And this one is a woman's best friend when they're going through menopause. Like they have an eat flush, or they get irritable, or don't want to be talked to. Well, this one is very good for them to take. And I can testify about it because there's so many women that I've treated. I don't treat them, most of them. I just give them the herbs and they go and make their own tea. And they always said to me, well, this is the best thing I've ever had that really calmed me down. Okay, since I've been going through this menopause thing. Okay. So we're going to go over to the cowfoot leaf.
Cowfoot leaf was for inflammation, right? For pain.
For pain in joints, pain ahead. So this one is the cowfoot leaf. And this cowfoot leaf is very powerful, simple to feet. If you have pains in your joints, pain in your back, pain in your head, wherever you have pain, you can just pick the leaves and warm them by the fire and put a towel over where you lay the warm leaf. And believe you me, within 5-10 minutes, if you feel relief. And you feel relief, because I had this pain in my knee once. I think I was doing something and I was praying my knee, like, and I put like 3 of these over there, and by the next morning I never feel it again. I was going to bed. And I've seen a lot of people that have helped with cowfoot leaves, and the older people that I know, they used to put it over all these pains. Different from the cowfoot leaf, if you notice. Yeah, this has the red and the stem, while the cowfoot leaves are green.
Mm-hmm. What is it used for?
And this one, I use it for like strain muscle. Like if I go to the bush and I strain my muscle, I will come down and I will pick the leaves, and then you can warm the leaves, beat it up into a poultice, and tie it, place it evenly over the muscle, and strap it on with a bandage, and so give yourself like 2-3 hours, if that much, the pain goes away.
And they make a tea from that as well?
Yes, you can make a tea, and we call it a cure hall. In the Maroon community, we call it a cure hall. And if you notice, it grows a lot around here because everybody drink it. And believe it or not, it cures a lot of things that we don't even know.
And we should say that this is also known by the name of Kava Kava in the U.S. and in Europe.
So in the U.S. and Europe, North America, people call this one Kava Kava. Yeah. But we call it Kava too, but that's like a common name, but the right name we call it is African Menti.
African Menti.
Yeah. And this one is good for pain. I mean, if you got pain, that you get like somebody hits you with something and it's caused a pain in any part of your body, you can just make some tea strong, boil it and make some strong tea and just sap the area where you get the hit. It's hard.
Can you take this internally?
Yeah, you can drink the cup of tea. You can make a cup of tea from the same one you're going
to
use.
But you apply it to an area that's been bruised?
Yeah. Anyway, you can get whales or like people beat you with a belt. Mm-hmm. Like for example, when the slaves used to get whipped on the plantation, this was one of the herbs that they use to relieve the pain. And they also can compound it with other herbs and make an herbal bath if you get seriously injured, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like fractured bones and bruised muscles and so on. Yeah.
Is that available by pill?
No.
You have to make the tea.
Yeah. You have to make the tea or the bath. That's what I know, yes.
Couscous has gotten popular.
Couscous grass, yeah. And the root of it, you can take it and make a tea for people who have something like bronchitis. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So we're going to write about this in our next book.
Pineapple?
Pineapples, they're not ready yet. They start shooting out like in February. And like by May, end of May, to the end of September. Yeah.
Is that arrow plant?
That's dasheen.
Oh.
And then cassava.
There's the cassava.
And the farrel over there. The
farrel over there. Yeah,
and sweet potato running on the ground. Mm-hmm. And this is sweet potato too as well.
Right, I have that grown at my house.
So this is the garden, this is the wild ops.
And hops.
This is one of the plants that's good for pain as well. You can compound
and it. And it's calming as well, yeah. Huh?
Calming, you know what I mean? If you have high blood pressure, if you have hypertension, you can make a tea from the plants, the flowers.
That looks just like propagated hops.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's the same thing.
Yeah.
It's the same thing, we have it growing wild up here.
There's sugar cane, I see.
Yeah. Coconut, star apple, janko bead, ginger, jack in the bush.
Where's your star apple now?
See the big tree there, that red tree up there. The star apple tree.
Uh-huh.
Not this one, this
one. Yeah, the one behind it. Yeah. I didn't know they got that big.
Yeah, they get big.
I had one in Florida, it was blown down by the hurricane.
Can see it's just forest, and that's the Blue Mountain Range, and that's the Janko Mountain Range over there. And then that is the chocolate tree, lime tree, elder.
Sorry, where's the chocolate tree again?
This one.
There.
There's chocolate on it right now.
And lime.
Elder. Trumpet. Okay. Then we have this one is a nice one to take this big bachelor button down. This is the Susumba.
Okay. I'm looking to see if I can zoom in on some chocolate. Oh, I see it up there.
Those are old. You want to come and see
a better one around?
Some better one, yeah.